Hey, Willie, two quick ones for you. First, you know, it's one thing to say stay ready, it's another when you're not playing. How do you stay ready and you know, come in and make this kind of an impact? And then I also wanted to ask you, Trey Young thought that you fouled him on that last play, just for your take on that play.
I mean, I'll answer that one first. I ain't even see Trey, so he's a smart kid. He was trying to get a quick little foul to shoot free throws to ice the game. No way that he was going to give him that call for the game. So good try, though. That was smooth. It was sneaky. And then the other thing is staying ready, man. I've just been getting extra work with Sham before and after practice and just trying to stay locked in. You know, that's one of the hardest things about this league is there's a lot of good players, and you just got to get it how you get it. And my big thing was like, man, how do I still get better without playing? So then we just started doing, you know, more scenario stuff after practice with Sham. And it showed today, the aggressiveness going towards the basket. And, you know, obviously the defensive side is good. But, you know, the offensive side we've been really crafting on the last week that I haven't played. And tonight I got an opportunity to go out there and just play with all my heart. And good things happen.
Kevin?
Willie winning the Defensive Player of the Game award tonight. What does that mean to you, not just from obviously winning the award itself, but from a confidence standpoint, knowing that you bringing that energy and defensive presence is something that you continue to do each night?
I mean, just like winning, you know what I mean? Like, I'll do anything to try to get our team to win, like whether it's scoring points, blocking shots, going to the dunker and just getting spaces, like it don't matter what I have to do. And I literally do anything. So, like, to that, it's just I'm going out there to play as hard as I can and just keep the space and keep the ball moving and make plays when it comes my way. Other than that, you know, just try to keep it simple.
Brad?
Yeah, well, if you don't mind, kind of an off-the-court question, you know, obviously the Mavs were in the news big time today with the national anthem talk. What does it mean to you as a player that Mark Cuban says you did that to rekindle conversation about racial equality and, you know, things that maybe were said this summer but maybe ignored?
You know, one thing I'll say about Mark is he's not scared of what's being talked about him. He's not scared of doing what's right. You know, with the anthem, he's got a lot of he's got a very diverse team, and you know, he advocates to that. And for us as players, like when your owner is behind you like that, and you know, that's a big society, like, you know, people think that's disrespect, and it's like, that's at the same time, that's what you know, our troops have fought for us, is that freedom to make that decision. It works both ways, is that freedom's full circle. Like, you know, a lot of people say, well, you know, it shows disrespect to the freedom that, you know, the fallen soldiers have given us. And it's like, well, that's that same respect goes full circle. Like, man, he you know, we got people that give their lives for us to make our decisions and for us to make free decisions. And I think that's like the biggest thing. When I woke up and read that, it was like, damn, like, he really is on some other, like, upper level. It's not just a business to him. And when you get to this level, like, it is such a business that when you have a guy to come out his character and that his character full shows and he's not being a businessman, he's being like a human, that's big time for a player to go through. And like, you'll run through a wall for that.
Wow, thank you. Let's go to